Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Sound Pulse. Today's video is going to be the start of our series on how to create visually stunning emails step by step. As the first impression matters, we'll kick off with headers, the first part subscribers see after they open your email. So, to offer you a quick overview, let's run through the three key sections of any email: header, body, and footer. A header is at the top of any email. It's the face of your company, as it should contain the company's logo, one of the most essential elements. There are other elements too, but we'll get on those a little bit later. It's worth noting that the header also includes a pre-header, the preview text displayed along with the subject line when the email is in the inbox. The second section is the body of an email. This stores the most important and conversion-oriented information. It usually contains images of promoted items, special offers, and core calls to action. And finally, the third section of an email is its footer. This sits at the bottoms of your email and houses your company's details, social media links, and a link to preference center or unsubscribe button. Now, it's time to give you a little more information about headers, the whole reason you've clicked on this video in the first place. So, your email has been opened and the user is skimming through. Great! Catching a subscriber's interest is an elite task now, so why not get started with header? There are three key areas you need to focus on to create a smart and eye-catching header: its content, its size, and its design. As for the content, it usually contains the company's name and logo, a menu bar, social media buttons, contact information, and a call to action. Choosing the right size for your header is also worth giving a thought. Your header should be between 600 and 700 pixels wide and 70 to 300 pixels high to ensure a proper view of email in displayed boxes. And while the content and size of the header are quite strict, its design gives full scope to your imagination. In case your muse is quiet, don't worry, Sound Pulse has got it covered. Here are the top tips we've come up with for creating an eye-catching header. First, try to add some color. It's not scientific. Color turns heads, sets mood, and grabs attention, if used in moderation, of course. Look how Yes! Lifecycle Marketing successfully used this option in their header. As a result, their header brightens up the whole email, making it look more lively. Second, play with contrast. You do not necessarily need to add garish colors to create contrast. You can use different fonts in your header instead. But keep in mind that not all fonts are displayed correctly by different email clients or mobile devices unless you embedded it into an image. Paperless Post, for example, designed a minimalistic header with their logo and company name, written in contrasting fonts. As you can see, they got a neat header that doesn't distract from the email's actual message. Let us know what you think in the comments below. Third, experiment with images in your header. Who said you should keep the header identical from email to email? Restyle the header to make it look fresh for your potential customer. Take a look at the example from Poncho. The weather forecaster changes headers depending on the time of day it sends the forecast. This trick brings novelty and diversity to Poncho's emails. You can also add a photo into the header to grab the subscriber's attention. Pearson's, an educational service, regularly invites subscribers to their workshops. To make their message more welcoming, they put a photo of one of their speakers in the header. The subscribers might not know them, but using his photo wins credibility for the company. And that's all for today. We hope this video has shed some light on how to create a kicky header for your emails. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications so you will be the first to see when we upload new videos. Thank you guys for watching and see you next time.